In this video, we shall do the historical analysis according to projection parameters. Projection parameters are nothing but projection criteria. Every business has a different projection criteria, and even one business may have multiple projection criteria also. So it is up to you to decide which parameter is most suitable for the business on which you are preparing the financial model. There are various factors that you need to consider before you decide the projection parameter, like what kind of business the company is operating in, what is industry best practice for projection in that business, what kind of information is available with you, and the most important is the objective of the financial model. We will have a separate discussion in which we shall talk about projection parameters in detail, but for this case study, we are taking growth rate and percentage as projection parameter. So we will be projecting revenue based on growth rate and other expense item as a percentage of sales. So what we have to do, we have to calculate the historical growth rate of revenue, and we have to calculate all expense items as a percentage of revenue historically first. So if you just go down, you see that I have already written the projection criteria. We will be calculating sales growth rate and COGS, SG&A and others expenses as a percentage of revenue. Depreciation and amortization will have separate schedules. So I am not calculating depreciation as a percentage of anything right now. Next, we have interest expense. So interest expense will be calculated based on debt. So we will have a separate discussion on this as well. Then we have taxes. Taxes will be projected as a percentage of pre-tax income. So in history, we have to calculate effective tax rate. Then next item is reserve. Reserves will be projected as a percentage of net income. So reserves will be calculated as percentage of PAT first in history. Then we have common dividend. Common dividend we will project as a percentage of PAT. So we will calculate dividend payout ratio. Then we have preferred dividend. Preferred dividend we will calculate as a percentage of preferred stock. So we are calculating preferred dividend rate in history. Then we have DDT on common stock and DDT on preferred dividend. So we will be calculating DDT rate on both common dividend and preferred dividend. And at last we have calculation for EPS. So we will be projecting them in a separate video. So for now, let us do the historical calculation. In 2011, we cannot calculate growth rate, because to calculate growth rate of 2011, we need to know the revenue of 2010 also. So I'll calculate the growth rate in 2012. So put in equal and go to sales of the current year 2012 divide by sales of 2011 minus 1, and this will give us the growth rate. Simply select the range, press Ctrl R. Here you can see that growth rate is coming in number format. We need to convert it to percentage format. So press Ctrl Shift percentage and it will be converted to percentage format. Just see that. Next, we have COGS as a percentage of sales. That can be calculated for 2011 year also. So put in equal, take COGS of 2011 divide by sales of 2011 only. Enter. Select the range, press Ctrl R. To convert it to percentage format, press Ctrl Shift percentage. Now do it for SG&A and others also. Put in equal, SG&A divided by sales, enter, equal to, go back again, take others divided by sales, enter. Now select the range and press Ctrl R. To convert this to percentage format, press Ctrl Shift percentage. Now if you just go above and check, we have one more item, that is stock based compensation. But for stock based compensation, we have not written any percentage criteria. So let me insert one row here, SBC as a percentage of sales equal to, go up, take SBC divided by sales, enter. Select the range, press Ctrl R, Ctrl Shift percentage to convert it to percentage format. Next we have tax rate. So equal to go up. Now take income tax divide by pre-tax income. This will give us effective tax rate. Select the range, press Ctrl R, Ctrl Shift percentage. Then we have reserves equal to reserves divide by PAT. Select Ctrl R, Ctrl Shift percentage. Next item we have common dividend. We are projecting common dividend based on dividend payout ratio. So put in equal here, common dividend divide by PAT. Then we have preferred dividend rate. So put in equal, take preferred dividend divide by preferred stock. We have preferred stock in the balance sheet. So go to balance sheet and here we have, just go down. Here we have preferred stock. Press enter. It is just 9%. Select the range, press Ctrl R. Then we have DDT rate of common dividend. So put in equal DDT on common dividend divided by common dividend. Enter. Ctrl R. Select the next row. Press Ctrl D. So what we have done in this video? In this video we have understood how to do the historical analysis according to the projection parameters. Now based on this historical analysis, we can write the assumptions for future, and based on those assumptions, we can make a forecast of the income statement, and that we will do in the next video.